gabi sa tanan. Welcome sa itong Sunday Night Online Service. And this time, bilita maglangan, let us praise the Lord. At wala yung pagkakantaon, karing a song, Higher Ground. Let us aim the higher ground that God wants us to be. Higher ground. I'm pressing on the upward way, new heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I'm onward bound, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's stable land. A higher plane that I have found, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. My heart has no desire to stay, where doubts arise and fears dismay. Though some may dwell where these abound, my prayer, my aim is higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's stable land. A higher plane that I have found, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. I want to live above the world, though Satan starts at me or hurled. For faith has caught the joyful sound, the song of saints on higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's stable land. A higher plane that I have found, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. I want to scale the utmost height and catch the gleam of glory bright. But still I pray till hand I found, Lord, lead me on to higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's stable land. A higher plane that I have found, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer and ask God to bless our service tonight. Pray for Makmak Palapio. Also pray for Floor Papila. She's been very sick in the hospital. I think she may have to have dialysis. We don't know. She's not doing very good. Pray for Floor Papila. She's been in our church since the beginning. Pray for the Cedeno family, Michael and his family, and the death of his wife. Pray for our Brigada ministry, that God would open up a door that we could minister more for to reach people here in General Santos City. And let's go to the Lord in prayer and ask God to bless here tonight. Lord, we love you, but oh God, help us to love you more. Help us to love you more than this world. And you tell us that's the greatest commandment, is to love you. We love you tonight, Lord. But increase our love and loving you more and more. And God, I pray here tonight, you bless the service. I pray, God, that you'd help people that have lost loved ones, people that are sick. God, we put our church and our members in your hands. The devil fights and fights and fights. I pray that our people would be encouraged tonight through this service in Christ's name. Amen. Just a couple announcements. Do not forget about every Sunday morning. This morning we had service at 7 o'clock, 8:30, and 10 o'clock. And God's blessing our service. Let me encourage you to be faithful. And then on Wednesday night, 5 o'clock, and 6 o'clock. And we have King's Kids on Wednesday night at 6 o'clock. And men's prayer meeting this coming Wednesday morning. Men, let me ask you, let me encourage you, stay on your knees. Men, stay on your knees. Life may be hard, but I'll tell you this, you learn to get on your knees, and life becomes a little bit easier because you put in God into your situation. Wednesday morning, every Wednesday morning, 6 a.m. Do not forget about that. Let me say this to our members. Be faithful. You be faithful. More required of a steward that a man be found faithful. Be faithful to the Lord and grow. You're not going to grow if you're not in church. While I go to church some, you're not going to grow. And everybody's going to pass you up. They're going to pass you up spiritually. You be faithful and you grow in your Christian life. You grow. Don't be the same. Anything that's alive grows. Don't be dead spiritually. Grow in your spiritual life. Stay in church. Stay in church. Stay in your Bible. But if you don't stay in church, you're not going to read the Bible very much. Stay in church. Stay in your Bible. Stay on your knees. Ask and it shall be given. Ask and it shall be given. Stay on your knees. And then also, you want to grow? Stay in church. Stay in your Bible. Stay on your knees. And stay after lost people. Stay after lost people. Oh, the field is white. You know why we don't witness sometime? Sometime we have things in our life. Second reason, we're afraid somebody's going to argue. Nobody can argue with you when you talk to them about the Lord unless you argue back. You know how to win an argument? Don't argue. So you stay faithful and you serve the Lord. David Jones is going to come back at this time. And another song. And then we have a special. And Rolando is going to come and speak to us tonight. And let the Word of God. You know what we need? We need more of God's word and less of this world. I don't need the wisdom of the world. I don't need the guidance of the world. I don't need the influence of the world. I don't get my directions from the ungodly. I want to get it from the word of the living God. And you sing with us this time. David Jones, you come.
Maayong gabi ulit sa tanan. Ato ni pakakanta ko ni isa ka-tremendous song. He keeps me singing. Jesus wants us to keep on singing in the midst sa toa mga problema. He keeps me singing. Get up.
There's within my heart a melody. Jesus whispers sweet and low. Fear not, I am with thee. Peace be still in all love's life, heaven flow. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know, fills my every longing, keeps me singing as I go. Oh, my life was wrecked by sin and strife, discord filled my heart with pain. Jesus wept across the broken strings, stirred the slumbering chords again. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know, fills my every longing, keeps me singing as I go. Feasting on the riches of His grace, resting at His sheltering wings, always looking on His smiling face. That is why I shout and sing. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know, fills my every longing, keeps me singing as I go. Though sometimes He leads through water deep, trials fall across the way, though Though sometimes the path seems rough and steep, see his footprints all the way. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know, fills my every longing, keeps me singing as I go.
Amen. Good singing this night, and this time a Minotaog special.
Into middle of the darkness, when I'm looking hard for hope, when I'm drifting toward the wrecks of fear, afraid that I'm alone, when I can't see beyond today, I'm sure of what is true. I turn my heart in silent prayer to all I know of you.
Are the faithful Father, timeless in your loving plan. Still you are the place of shelter in this lost and barren land. Still you are the God of heaven, forever in your hand. You revealed yourself to be the great I am, and still you are.
I can never understand it, how your love remains the same. In a world that's full of restless heart, in a constant state of change,
you've proven that you're worthy, Lord. On the trust I place in you, you've been through all the ages past, the only source of truth. Still you are the faithful Father, timeless in your loving plan. Still you are the place of shelter in this lost and barren land. Still you are the God of heaven, forever's in your hand. You revealed yourself to be the great I am, the great I am. Still you are the faithful Father, timeless in your loving plan. Still you are the place of shelter in this lost and barren land. Still you are the God of heaven, forever's in your hand. You revealed yourself to be the great I am. Still you are God of heaven, forever's in your hand. You revealed yourself to be the great I am, and still you are. Still you are. Still you
Good evening to everyone. So tonight, welcome sa Sunday night service. And we thank the Lord for giving us this opportunity again that we can worship Him. And open your Bible in the book of Acts chapter 9. Salamat sa Ginoo for this opportunity He gave me to speak, to teach and preach the Word of God. Acts chapter 9, this is the story of the Apostle Paul. Paul, his name, before he got saved, was Saul. And tonight, let us study the life of the Apostle Paul and learn something from his life that something we can learn and apply into our lives from the life of the Apostle Paul. Chapter 9, verse 1 down to verse 6. And Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest, and desired of him letters to Damascus, to the synagogues, that if he found any this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven, and he fell to the earth, and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he trembling and astonished, and said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise, and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. Shall we pray? Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for your word. We ask you, Lord, to bless thy word. Bless this message, Lord. Help me to deliver this message. In Jesus' name, amen. So, atong nakita diri sa kinabuhi ni Apostol Pablo, we know nga si Apostol Pablo, before he got saved, he is a persecutor of the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Siya ang ginaimo niya, ginapangita niya ang mga followers ni Jesus Christ, the disciples of Christ, and naisay listahan, muadto sa synagogues, sa mga sinagoga, o pangitaon ka itong mga tao nga naisay ang listahan, and then kung makita niya, iyang ipadakop, ipadala sa Jerusalem para ipapatay niya. That is the work of the Apostle Paul. But one day, Apostle Paul met the Lord Jesus Christ. Nakilala niya si Kristo Jesus. And again in verse 6, I will read. And he trembling and astonished said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? So this is the turning point of the Apostle Paul. From a lost person to a saved person. From a persecutor to a believer to a preacher. And notice here, Paul is surrendering now his life. Ug maupod ka na igsuon ni gala. Sa dihang giluwas kita sa Ginoo, ang atong kinabuhi, ginapanagiha na sa Ginoo. Ug angay lang, ug takos lang ang atong kinabuhi, ato lang isurrender sa Ginoo. Maingon kita, Lord, ano ang kabubuto nimo sa akong kinabuhi? Lord, ano ang plano nimo sa akong kinabuhi? Ni ako, Ginoo, unsa ang gusto nimo himuon? That is a Christian life. Our life belongs to God. We are purchased by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And notice here in verse 6, nine instruction. Arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. Igsoon ni gala, naay purpose ang kita giluwas sa Ginoo. After we got saved, ang Ginoo naa siya mga instruction, naa siya plano. Kung unsa yung gusto ng pahimo nato, notice ang gisulti sa Ginoo, arise and go into the city, that it shall be told thee what thou must do. There are many things that we want, God wants us to do after we got saved. Damo sang kinanglan naton nga buhaton human kita giluwas sa Ginoo. So aton kinitun-an kining kinabuhi ni Pablo. Atong abrion another verse in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Another statement of the Apostle Paul, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17. Paul said, Therefore if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So ang title sa minsay tonight from the Word of God, All Things Are Become New. We know si Apostle Paul, ang iyang kinabuhi before he got saved, he was a bad person. He is a persecutor. But when Paul got saved, his life was greatly changed. Paul became a preacher. Si Paul siya ang responsible sa pag-spread out sang gospel from Jerusalem down to Europe, Asia, and America, and to us here in Asia, in the Philippines. Si Pablo ang responsable sa pagpalapnag sang pulong sang Ginoo. Hinungdan na kita nakadawat sang gospel. Si Apostle Paul siya ang nagsulat sang most of the books in the New Testament. About 12 books in the New Testament that Paul wrote. So the evidence of being saved is a changed life. Amuning makita naton sa life ni Pablo. There is an evidence kung ikaw saved. By the way, kung kita nakabaton sa kaluwasan, may ilhanan, may kausaban ba? So all things are become new. This is the message. First of all, ano ang mga butang nga nabago sa atong kinabuhi sa diyang kita giluwas sa Ginoo? First of all, we belong to a new family. The Bible tells us that there are two spiritual families. There are two spiritual families in the Bible. First, the devil's family. Before we got saved by physical birth, the Bible tells us that we belong to the devil's family. Sa dihang natao ta dinhi sa yuta, immediately nasakop ta sa pamilya sa Diablo. Why? Because Adam and Eve was tempted in the Garden of Eden, and we are the descendants of Adam and Eve. We inherited the sinful nature of Adam. Please open your Bible in 1 John chapter 3, verse 10. The Bible tells us, in this the children of God, notice the children of God, are manifest. May ilhanan, may manifestation kung ang isang tao ay ligtas, siya ay anak ng Diyos. And the children of the devil. So two families, children of God and the children of the devil. Whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God, neither he that loveth not his brother. So, two families. Second, the first family is the devil's family. Second, the God's family. Nung tayo ay naligtas, tayo ay naging anak na ng Diyos. Ayo, according to the Galatians chapter 3, verse 26, the Bible tells us, for you are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. So, mga otorikson, kung kita luwas, nanatay relasyon sa Ginoo, amahan o anak. O kana nga relasyon, kana dili na gyud mawala. That's why the Bible tells us that once you are truly saved, you cannot lose your salvation. We have the assurance of salvation. We are the child of God. But if you are not saved, you must be born again into the family of God through the blood of Jesus Christ. If you are not born again into the family of God, you cannot enter in the house of God, that is heaven. So there are, first of all things are become new. What are the new things? New family. Pag ikaw ay ligtas, we belong to the family of God. Before, we belong to the family of the devil. And then number two, all things are become new. Galatians chapter 13, this is the life of Apostle Paul. Paul said in Galatians chapter 1, verse 13, for you have heard of my conversation in time past in the Jewish religion, how that beyond measure I persecuted the church of God and wasted it. 14, and profited in the Jewish religion above many my equals in my own nation, being more exceedingly zealous of the tradition of my fathers. So Paul said, sa karaan niyang kinabuhi, in time past, Paul was very religious. We have noticed here, religion is mentioned two times. Paul was a religious person before siya naluwas. At sabi ni Paul, and wasted it. So ibig sabihin, ang gustong sabihin ni Pablo, na bago siya naligtas, ang lahat niyang ginawa ay para lamang sa reliyon. Okay, wala pong kabuluhan, sabi niya, and wasted it. Sabi pa ni Pablo, he was zealous of the tradition. He was very enthusiastic. Kana bang si Paul, kugihan kayo sa iyang trabaho, sa iyang paguna-una, ngayon sakto iyang gihimo. Pero di ay, kato, para lang sa reliyon. Matod pa na ako yung dunggan nga preacher, ingon siya, religion makes us religious, but Christ makes us righteous. So ato makita, there is a new belief. Paul has a new belief. Sa una, he has religion, he has tradition, but now Paul has the true faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Igsunigala, the Bible is our source of faith. Ingon sa Biblia, Romans 10:17, so then faith cometh by hearing. Kung kita naluwas, hinahinay naton sundon kining pulong sa Ginoo. When I got saved at the age of 36, before I was a very religious person, og daghang kong pagtuo nga sa akong hunahuna, insakto kadto. But then later on, when I got saved, hinahinay ko nagbasa sa Bible, hinahinay ko nagtuon sa Biblia, na ako permi sa simbahan, nagapaminaw sa pulong sa Ginoo, na-realize na ako, nga daghan di ay, ang akong mali nga tinuohan. Wala sa Bible. So akong gihimo, akong gibiyaan katong mali nga pagtuo. Wrong beliefs, akong gibiyaan, I follow the Word of God. The Bible is our authority. That's why we have to read this book, study this book, and obey this book. Aron kita di masaag. Aron kita dili ma-confuse. Kay karong panahon, daghan baya ang mga mini nga magtutudlo. Kanang nagalibot-libot sa atong mga lugar, nagasuroy, nagatudlo, mga pulong sa Ginoo, kasagaran daghan diya nga dili sakto iling mensahe. Kung kita nagatuon sa pulong sa Ginoo, kahibalo ta what is right and what is wrong. So we must stay on the Bible. We must have to have a right belief, right faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And then number three, so all things are new. What are the new things nga itong makita sa itong kinabuhi? The evidence of being saved is a new life. First of all, we become the family of God. There is new family. From the devil's family, kita nahimong sakop sa pamilya sa Ginoo. And then, new belief. From old belief, religion, tradition, we have now the right belief, and that is the Bible. And then third, Paul, sa kinabuhi ni Pablo, human siya naluwas, nabago iyang desire, nabago iyang nga pangtanaw sa iyang pagtuo. Aktong tanawon ka Diyot sa Romans chapter 10, verse 1 to 2. Romans chapter 10, verses 1 to 2. Book of Romans, chapter 1 or chapter 10. Paul said, "Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved." Usbon ako, "Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved." So si Pablo na siya'y pagtanaw, na siya'y dako nga handong, na siya'y desire nga mga tao nga wa naluwas unta makaangkod pud sa kaluwasan sama sa naangko ni Pablo. Sama usab nato kung kita giluwas sa Ginoo na tay gospel message kina dawatan, kita usab dapat magkaroon ta og desire na tay handong, magkaroon ta og burden nga ang tao nga wa panaluwas kinanglan sila masuginlan, masultian sa mayong balita nga mao ang kaluwasan. Igsoon ni gala dili lang kabuboton sa Ginoo nga kinanglan mag-desire ta nga mangkabi ug kalag. Kana pod ginamando, ginakamand sa Ginoo nga kita mangkabi ug kalag. We as Christians should have a desire to reach the lost with the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Romans chapter 1, verse 14 down to 6. Romans chapter 1, verses 1 or verses 14 to 16. This is the statement of the Apostle Paul. Paul said, "I am debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise." Ang buot ipasabot ni Pablo nga siya na idakong kabalaslan. Si Pablo murabag utangan nga numan tungod sa kaluwasan nga naangkon niya, tungod sa gospel nga naa niya. Both to the Greeks, barbarians, unsa man ang Greeks o barbarians? Mao kini ang mga lain-lain na klase sa tao. Greeks are the higher class of the people during the time. Barbarians, katong mga mubo, mga less civilized ng mga tao. But pasabot, si Pablo na ay kabugaton, na siya desire nga ang mga tao makabaton sa kalawasan. Nga naman, in verse 15, "So as much as in me is, kay tungod anaan ako unsa ang anaan ni Pablo, ang kalawasan nga naangkon niya, ang minsay sa kalawasan nga anaan ka niya. So as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greeks." So igsunigala kung kita luwas na tay responsibilidad to give out the gospel. Kinsa pa man ang mag-reach out sa tao nga wa na luwas. If we have the gospel, we are responsible to give out the gospel. Ang tao nga walay kaluwasan, ang mga tao nga walay mensahe nga nadawat, di po sila makatag isang sakto nga mensahe. Kita nga na'y mensahe, we are responsible to reach the people that are lost. So, Paul has a new desire. Not only that Paul has a desire to win souls, but also we can see in the Bible that God wants us to live a clean life for His vessel. Ang gusto sa Ginoo nga kita manginabuhi, nga kita manginabuhi limpyo, tarong atubang sa Ginoo kay kita sudlanan nga galamiton sa Ginoo. In 2 Timothy chapter 2, 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19. Ingon sa Biblia, verse 19, 2 Timothy chapter 2. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Ingon ni Pablo, ingon diri sa Biblia, kung kinsa man katong Kristohanon, katong nagadala o pangalan ni Kristo, kinahanglan kita magbiya sa sala. Nga naman, because we are the vessel of God, kita sudlanan nga gamiton sa Ginoo. Unya kung atong kinabuhi, hugaw, dili kita magamit sa Ginoo. Verse 20, but in great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself from this, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified. Sanctified means set apart, sanctified and meet for the master's use, and prepared for every good work. So gusto sa Ginoo nga kita iyang gamiton. Kita sudlanan nga gamiton sa Ginoo. Busa, God wants us to live a clean life. A sinful life is not pleasing to God. A sinful life is we can lose our testimony if we live in sin. So God wants us to win lost souls, and not only to win lost souls, but also ang Ginoo gusto niya na kita limpyo nga sudlanan para sa iyang buluhaton. So Paul has a new desire. Mauna nga si Pablo sa iyang ministry. Ang iyang ministry is to siya ang responsible sa pag spread out sang gospel from Jerusalem to Europe, Asia, America, ug uban pang nasod. Siya ang responsible sa pag-spread out to the uttermost part of the earth. So, what are the new things? First of all, when we got saved, we become a member, we have a new family, we have a new belief, and we have a new desire. Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. Verse 1. Desire. Unsa ang atong desire? Sawa patanaluas, kasagaran ang atong gini-desire sa kinabuhi para lamang sa material nga bagay, para lang sa atong kagalingon, para sa undanon natong panginanglanon. Apan igso ni gala sa diyang giluwas kita sa Ginoo, ang gusto sa Ginoo ang atong handom, ang atong huna-huna. Ang atong desire kinahanglan na sa mga eternal nga butang. Ang mga butang iya sa Ginoo. Colossians chapter 1 verse 3, verse 1. Chapter 3 verse 1. If you then be risen with Christ, that means if you are saved, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth at the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above and not on the things of the earth. Maunay handom sa Ginoo. That should be our desire. Mga buluhaton sa Ginoo. Okay, pangkabig o kalag, maunay handom ang dapat nato handumon sa atong kinabuhi. Kaya mga butang temporal, dili ka na maglugay. Ang mga butang eternal, sama sa kalag, pulong sa Ginoo, maoy na eternal value. So, all things are become new. Number four. Atong abriyon sa atong Biblia. Sa kinabuhi ni Pablo, balikan natin ang Acts chapter 9. Si Pablo, sa diyang siya naluwas, atong makita from chapter 9, Paul got saved. And then chapter 13, Paul became a missionary leader for the first mission trip in the book of Acts, sa una-unang simbahan. But manotis nato from chapter 9 to chapter 12, si Apostle Paul, naa siya sa saktong lugar, meaning naa siya'y ang iyang ginakauban, mao ang saktong mga tao. Naa siya permi kanunay sa pundok uban sa mga kauban niyang aluwas, mga disciples. Hinoon si Pablo diri bago pa naluwas. In fact, ang other disciples, dili makatuon niya nga siya naluwas na, nga siya usap ka-disciple. Apan, makita nato dini sa life ni Pablo, nga nagpabilin siya, nga faithful sa pagtigom. O niya, kauban niya, ang mga isig kapareho niya ang mga disciples. Atong tanawon in Acts chapter 9 verse 26. And when Saul, this is Paul, was come to Jerusalem, he assayed means he attempt to join himself to the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and believed not that he was a disciple. Verse 27, but Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles and declared unto them how he had seen the Lord. So manotis na to, na'y disciple din he, old believer, matured na Christian, while si Paul was a new Christian, si Barnabas, gitabangan niya si Pablo. In verse 28, and he, that is Paul, and he was with them, kauban niya ang mga disciples who had been saved, mga dugay na nag-uban ni Kristo, coming in and going out at Jerusalem. Tuwa sila pirmi nagtigom sa simbahan, kaya unang simbahan sa Jerusalem. Giingon din ni, coming in and going out. That means they are always, napirmi sila kanunay sa pagtigom sa simbahan. In chapter 11, verse 25, then departed Barnabas to Tarsus to seek Saul. Again, atong una-unaon nga si Pablo, bago pa siya na-save din ni. But there are some Christians or other disciples nga mas naunin niya na kunsadiin kini sila nagtabang ni Pablo. And when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. And it came to pass that a whole year they assembled themselves with the church. Nagtigom sila sa simbahan, church, and taught much people, and the disciples were called Christians first at Antioch. So, there is a new companion kung ito makita. Paul had a new companion. Before si Pablo nakaila sa Ginoo, ay ang kauban, katong mga persecutor. Busa apan karon sa diyang si Pablo nakaila, naluwa si Pablo, naanis sa pirmi kanunay sa pagtigom. Ikso ni Gala, bago man ta naluwas, maybe you are a new convert, o bisan pa man ikaw dugay na naluwas, importante ikso ni Gala ang pagtigom sa mga Kristuhanon. Kinahanglan na tapirmi sa pundok. Nganuman, it is in the church where there is a teaching and a preaching of the Word of God. It is in the church where we can have a fellowship with the right person. Na din ha ang mga tao nga sakto na to nga ubanan. Yes, maybe na daghan man ang tao sa church na dili man tanan siguro perfect. But the right place after we got saved is to be faithful to the local church. The church is very important after we get saved. We can hear the teaching, the preaching of the Word of God. When we are in the church, na tay protection. It is in the church where there is a man of God will guide us, will instruct us. That is the pastor. So there is always a benefit kung kita faithful sa pagtigom sa simbahan. Do not forsake church. You cannot serve God outside the local church. And you will not grow if you are not faithful to the local church. If you are faithful to the local church sa pagtigom, that is the very first step na kita mag-involve sa buluhatan sa Ginoo. Nga naman dagang Kristuhanon is not involved in the work of God, in the ministry, because first of all, they are not faithful to the church. So, church, serving the Lord, the first of all, kinahanglan mag-faithful ka sa simbahan. So that is the new things na itong makita sa kinabuhi ni Pablo. Sa tibok niyang kinabuhi, naa siya permi sa simbahan, niya siya nagtubo. And then third, or number four, all things are become new. We become, belong to the new family. We become to have a new belief, bagong pagtuo. And then, we have a new desire. And then last, or third, or number four, we have a new destination. So, ni Gala, siyempre kay Baluta, once you are saved, the Bible tells us that we have everlasting life. Ikso ni Gala, duha lang kalugar. Okay? Ang gitudlo sa Biblia. Kung ikaw saved, ang Biblia nag-ingon, there is heaven. Kung bili ka saved, if you are not saved, ang Bible nagtudlo na there is everlasting punishment. Paul said in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 6 and 8, sabi ni Pablo, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And to be present with the Lord is to be absent from the body. So, ikso ni Gala, wala sang lugar in between heaven and hell. There is no place of destination akong sa diin in between sa langit o sa impyerno. So there is only two places. Paul had a new destination. Before we got saved, kita padulong sa impyerno. Now that we are saved, the Bible tells us, the moment we got saved, kita padulong na sa heaven. O kana dili na gyud na usab. And that is our hope. Mao na atong paglaom. Busa sa pagpangalagad sa Ginoo, usahay, usahay na ikawadon, na ay problema, dagang pagsulay, pero natay hope. And that is the hope of heaven. Mao na nga dili ta dapat magundang, dili ta dapat magka-discourage, magpabilin nga discourage. Kaya atong una-unaon, nga na ay gipromise ang Ginoo, na one day, we'll go to the place called heaven. Atong abriyon in Titus chapter 1. Titus chapter 1. Titus chapter 1, verse 2. The book of Titus. The Bible tells us, Titus chapter 1, verse 2. In hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began. Ingon sa Bible, God cannot lie. In hope of eternal life, which God, that cannot lie, promised before the world began. Chapter 2, verse 13. Looking for that blessed hope, that is the coming of Christ, and the glorious appearing of the great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. So, igsunigala, natay nindot nga paglaom. Natay destination. Okay? Once you are saved, one day, ang promise sa Ginoo, nga kita magpuyo hangtod dito sa iyaha. But if you are not saved, wala tayong paglaom. Ang atong destinasyon mao ang silot nga walay katapusan. So igsunigala, naay kabaguhan ang tinunood nga tawo nga luwas sama ni Pablo. Nabay kabaguhan sa imong kinabuhi. The evidence of being saved is a changed life. So first of all, unsa ang mga kabaguhan nga atong makita? Kita na himong membro sa pamilya sa Ginoo. Kun ikaw luwas, anak na ta sa Ginoo, di na kana mawala ang atong relasyon. Permanente. Kita save. Second, natay mga bag-o nga pagtuo. Katong daang pagtuo nato, biyaan nato. Usahay lisod biyaan ang daang pagtuo, especially kung kita idara na naluwas, dugay ta na ulipon sa atong laang reliyon. Just like nako, dugay ko na ulipon sa akong reliyon. Sometimes lisod biyaan. But the Bible will show us what is right and what is wrong. Our belief should come from the Word of God. And then number three, new desire. Unsa ba itong desire sa atong kinabuhi? First of all, we have to desire the things of God. Souls. We must get involved in winning souls, reaching people for Christ. And then third, fourth, the company. We must live with the people na kung sa diin, kaubanon nato. Be faithful to the church kung sa diin, naadiha atong mga kaubanan na makatabang nato. And then last, the new destination. We have hope. One day, we will live forever in heaven. That is a challenge to us. As a Christian, natay paglaom, natay hope of heaven. Magampo kita, Ginoong Diyos, salamat, Ginoong, sa imong pulong. Salamat sa Biblia. Kining tanan, akong pagampo, Jesus' name. Amen.